I'm Travis.
So hey, we're here again, first times first, to talk about something we did a few months ago. So, we went through a corn maze.
Yes, we went through the Danville corn maze in particular this year.
Danville?
Mm-hmm. Did I say Danville?
Oh, sorry, no, let's just forget that, sorry. It's okay. But we went through this corn maze, as Travis said, and it took us quite a while. I mean, there was a lot of complaining, you know, we were sweating. It was like living hell almost. And,
it was pretty bad.
Yeah, I was very happy to get through it and eventually get done with it. But we decided, that this was an enormously challenging corn maze, and we thought, if you ever thought about going to a corn maze, because I'm sure that corn maze will be open up again next fall, mm-hmm. and possibly over the summer, presumably, there's a pattern you have to take to get through a corn maze.
Yeah, the interesting thing about the Danville corn maze is that every year they change the design of the corn maze. So this year the theme was dinosaurs, so if you look at it from above, it looks like a bunch of dinosaurs. And then last year was like an alien theme, so...
I wasn't there, but
that's all right. But every year they change it, like, they've had one year like an Indian theme, I think they had one of an eagle one time. And they change it every year, so every year going through the corn maze is definitely, it's totally different, and it's a whole kind of challenge on its own.
Listen to the expert over here. He's been through it more than once. This was only my first time going through the corn maze.
I would say the easiest way to do it, what I found personally, is just try to get into the middle of the corn maze as quick as you can, because then from there you have options of where you want to go. When we went... at the start of the corn maze, you have like 5 routes you can take. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, that's what they call them. And so you just take one and you kind of run with it. But over time, you can circle back around and start at the beginning again. And we did that a couple times. But one of the things I feel that helps the most is like a vantage point. And at the Danville corn maze, they have... 2 or 3 bridges, and they have like a boat. I think that's it. But one of the best things I think helped us was getting up on the bridge to see where we were at the corn maze.
Well, we sort of had help because we had to constantly get that guy to keep telling us examples.
Yeah. The good thing is they have a couple helpers within the corn maze, so in case you get lost, they're there to kind of guide you in the right direction, and they'll give you hints depending on how lost you are or how frustrated you are with the maze, which was kind of nice because they didn't outright tell us how to get through the maze, so they kind of guided us, like, in the direction we wanted to go, like north or south or whatever.
Holy fireballs!
Yeah. So, I had a great time, but we got lost for quite a while, didn't we?
Yeah, well, it was kind of frustrating because, to speak, because you've been taking all the attention. No, I'm just kidding. We were kind of running around, and I swore, like, you know, we were being chased by birds or something. You know, like,
we could follow the bird sounds
or whatever. Yeah. And, you know, it was like, he'd tell us, with a guy over there, you know, he wore sunglasses and he would tell us where to go. But it seemed like, you know, we'd constantly keep, you know, running around in circles.
Yeah, we got really stuck in one part of the corn maze, didn't we? It was pretty bad. We got stuck in, like, the bottom left corner, I think, for a long time.
Oh, we did. I had to finish my whole, like, you know, I brought a water bottle along, and it was like, you know, obviously I had to finish it because I was sweating, and I was complaining.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. I think it took us just over 2 hours, just a little over 2 hours to do it. And the people there said typically takes about 45 minutes to... Well, on average, it's like 45 minutes to like 3 or 4 hours. It's kind of, it can be an all-day thing. But I think they mentioned people go through the maze consistently. And people who go through it a lot, they try to do like speed runs for times, kind of like you do in like video games. And some people can do the whole corn maze in 10 minutes by running through it.
Yeah, well, thanks for speaking with me, Travis. I wanted to just give you that little interview, talk about a corn maze. So, huzzah out of here, and whoa the ways, and that's the corn maze.
All right. See you guys next time.
Mm-hmm. Yep.